is a fully customizable automatic brewing system. So basically, to explain it quickly here, I have this fully customized, fully codable redstone pattern. You don't need these repeaters here, I just had them there because I wanted them there. So basically, we have a redstone line going up here. I changed it up a little bit over there, but it's minute, and the changes are. And the redstone up here will power the block, powering the piston, making the piston extend, and powering this redstone line, dispensing this item. Using this, I put different pistons in different locations to power different dispensers, meaning that I could have like this. Meaning I could have this one dispense a grass block and a dirt block, but not any of the other blocks. I could have this one dispense a grass path, a stone block, and a sand block. And again, so that's the basic idea. And this is basically infinitely expandable. It may get a little bit glitchy with if you have it long enough so that you unload the dispensers, it might get a bit glitchy. Then I haven't built one that big. Anyway, so that's the basic idea of how of everything. I use redstone torches just because it just so happened to be the right time to use them. And it meant I had to put in less sticky pistons here because they inevitably power the dispenser that dispenses the Neverwort. Now let me go over some key things here. The placement of the dispensers. Because some recipes for potions will require multiple things like the golden carrot and fermented spider eye for, I can't remember where it was, but that's used in a certain brewing. Both of them are used, but you have to put, yes, invisibility, no invisibility, I don't know, anyway. So you have to dispense a carrot first and then the Neverwort. Otherwise, if they get dispensed the other way around, they'll go in the hopper and it just won't work in the brewing system and it'll just be a bit annoying. Another thing I had to do is over here I've had to put a major delay on dispensing the gunpowder to make absolutely sure that it would not and could not like go into the hopper before redstone or glowstone, because I would just break it and I had to put a block in there because sometimes it would just fly off to the side for some reason, meaning that it would not even go into the water stream to go into the hopper to go into the brewing stack in the first place. So we have all of them here. This one's just a fermented spider eye because there's a couple of potions that only need a potion plus a fermented spider eye to make the potion. So here we have like blocks of redstone. So these are the ones that are splash. These are the ones that have redstone. These are the ones that have glowstone in it, and then the others are just unique ingredients. Anyway. So, let me see if I can get it here. So, we press this button to make a potion of strength. I did not know it would cause the signs to pop off. You saw the pistons there. I just put the signs there. I didn't actually realize they would pop off with the redstone torch updating. I just put them there on my own thing. You could look, or you use, like, just put a block this side or this side of the torch and put a sign on there if you're really that bothered. But yeah, as you can see here, we've had the Neverwort making the awkward potion, and the blaze powder is going in to make it a strength potion. And up here we have the glowstone dust to make it stronger so you do more damage. And for when that's finished, we have redstone back here. So we have a button, wooden button, that comes out here, wraps around, which powers this block, which will turn off this redstone torch, which will allow the potions to be emptied out of the brewing stand and into this chest. And while the button is pushed on, it'll also power this hopper, so So it doesn't just continuously load the bottles into there and while you're trying to unload it. Let me just refill the bottles. Yeah, I use shulker boxes for this design. You could always just do what I did here with this Jessica slab over it. I was just lazy and used shulker boxes. And so you can see here we have the potion of strength there, but potions. They go in there, and do they get filled with water bottles without any of them going into there? Onto this kind of spider. So I'm not going to show them all off, maybe. We have healing, speed, invisibility, regen, and poison as well. Now here, fermented spiders eye. Have healing or poison in the brewing stand to make harming or harming strength or regeneration for weakness, fire resistance or swiftness or slowness. So say we wanted to make or regen for weakness. So we wanted to make a weakness potion. We could go over here. Pop a strength potion in there. We have the Neverwort, we have the Glaze Powder, we have the Glowstone. And then when you just go over here, press that one, and it will dispense the fermented spider eye. You can see it there. Also I love the new sound effects for when a potion's being blued, it just goes glug 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 glug. Again, I do like. And obviously, you know, they're being brewed up. And the glowstone will go in. And the only problem with this is that, unless you already have it as a splash potion, so I don't currently have my strength as a splash potion. To fix that, all I would have to do is add four more blocks onto the end of there. Get that, not that, that there, and yeah. So you can change these after you've finished building it. So I can do that. Make it a splash potion of strength. And let me just get a bit of gunpowder here. So here we have potion of weakness for 1 minute 30. It halves your attack damage. There, you just have potion of weakness. Right. You may also have noticed I have not got every potion on here. That is to show off how this is infinitely expandable. And by that I mean, the problem with a brewing automatic brewing system is that sometimes you'll either have to make an individual machine to make each potion, which is a waste of space, time and resources in my opinion, rather than having one big machine that does them all. But the problem with one big machine that does them all is that if you have a new potion that's been introduced, which I am in the next update actually, in the aquatic update, I do actually believe there's going to be a new potion implemented, so that's when the larger all potion set in one thing will lack because you won't be able to update it easily. You'd have to bring and pick a new one. So here, this I didn't want a Neverwort going into there, so I just had a potion that didn't require gas tiers to use, so it's just like, okay, so this one or this, neither of these two required a gas tier. It doesn't have to be gas tier, it could be anything else that these two don't require. So I just knocked out those two pieces of redstone and built around it. And that if anything comes up where it does require a gas tier or anything that you need, anything, you know, the thing that you did, you could just you could easily just go up to the this dispenser and just say, okay, I want to swap that with that, and change over the pistons to you know, match that. So if you want to update it, it will require a little bit of tweaking, but not much. And let's just get easier. I'm just going to use iron blocks for now, for this, just for this demonstration. So we're just going to go up here. So say I wanted to make a potion of leaping. That's probably going to be a Neverwort. I'm doing this off memory, so forgive me if I'm wrong. And if it gets too long, to the point where, you know, it won't dispense, just put like a beta there or wherever, and then, you know, it'll fix that problem. So leaping, it's just like, oh well, I haven't got any rabbit's foot. Be it so, what I would have to do is add another dispenser onto here, which at this point in time, because of the awkward placement of the gunpowder, which I could have probably just put over here or something, but whatever, because of the awkward placement of the gunpowder, it's a bit difficult. So lesson to be learned, don't put anything at the end here. So you just to add, hopefully this will work out. Well, thankfully there's no redstone under there. Just get a dispenser. Get that there. This will just require a little bit of tweaking. So, so I'm gonna just smash that. Have that go to that, and then have a line here of redstone. And 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. So this one wants one, this one wants one, this one wants one, so does this one, and that one. Okay. So, also I've got a delay on these repeaters, so just to keep the timings correct, if I do need to extend it. So there you go, and now just extend the redstone a little bit. Remember to check to make sure that the redstone hasn't gone too long, so it's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, so it hasn't gone 12 out on the repeater, so that they will should all activate. Now let's go here. Well, no, we're not going to make this splash. So rabbit's foot is already going to have that thing, so let's make it so we can jump higher. Get repeat the redstone dust all the way around here. And if you need to put repeaters on, just put them where there aren't any sticky pistons, otherwise that's going to mess up the whole thing, which is mildly annoying. Extend the redstone. I'm not going to extend all of them, I'm just going to extend these two for now. If you were really adding a new one on, you would extend all of the redstone lines, so eventually you could just hook them all up. And then we go into here. Shove a stack of rabbit foot feet in there. Get a button. Press the button. And that should dispense all in the pop order. Like that. Glowstone. Did that not dispense? Oh, the redstone line probably went out. It's killing me. Yes, mate. No, the glowstone dust didn't come out. Oh, wait, yeah, this does have slightly one block shorter. Yeah, because I have that there, because then I can just look up and make sure they were all working. But let's take the glowstone dust out and try that again. And the water bottles. Awkward potions. Very awkward. And try that again. Yeah, we can see that they lit on that time. So we have rabbit foot, then glowstone dust. Yeah, it was successfully upgraded. You know, we added another module onto it. It wasn't. I made it a little bit more. I made it a bit more difficult than it had to be. Just like messing up with the redstone length, but it is infinitely expandable. You shouldn't have much if any problems expanding it, and it does automatically brew potions, and then you could have this like above your base somewhere, or you know, wherever, and then instead of having just like a double chest here, you could have like an entire potion storing room. But don't boost two. Press the button. I think the jump boost two is like one of the best looking potions there is. Those three were that one was also supposed to be splash potion, but somebody was messing with the machine while I was working on it. So it sort of didn't work properly. But yeah, that is a fully customizable, encodable potion brewing system in Minecraft. To be honest, this isn't really a system I've seen anybody use. Is it the most compact? No, because you can't have these next to each other. Like, if you could have like two lines of redstone next to each other without them interfering with each other, then you could half the space this takes up. Pretty much, but because you can't do that, and observers won't power the blocks underneath them, unlike this redstone, you can't use observers. So unless they implement like bluestone, like from Mamba Jumbo's April Fool's video, then this is pretty much as compact as you're going to get it. You could raise these dispensers up and put some of them on top of each other. The only problem with that is the redstone is really fiddly then. Like, this is the easiest way to lay it out. And stacking these dispensers on top of each other will literally just make it make all the redstone really fiddly. If you're going to move these dispensers at all, I would suggest moving them round the back. On the back of here, and then that would, you know, then that's one way of halving the length of it, but still that would make the redstone more fiddly, because you'd have them in the same space along like one of the axes, either X or Z, but on a different, but still in a different place area. It'll be a bit fiddly with the redstone, like having to take it from like round here up front to all the way around back. But yeah, if you think you can improve on this design, you know, make a video about it and send me a link, and I'll, if I think it's good enough, I'll show the video off. Mind you, that's not really too high praise going with somebody with 51 subscribers at last time I checked. But I think this is as compact and the best way to lay out, unless you are going, unless you're literally a redstone genius and building in a way that only redstone geniuses could even understand how you did it. Anyway, I'll see you guys in the next video. Back from my time off, like, if you do know, I've decided to take up to a week off every month, because YouTube isn't being too kind to daily channels, so I'm taking some time off once a month to just relax, come back more enthusiastic and energetic about everything, I have looked at my views just to see if any more of my videos have done any better, and it's just like, Taz Wanted and a couple of them did start doing very well. For some reason, Galaxy 2 didn't start doing better until today, where it actually did get promoted. But it's not necessarily always going to be 1 week. It might just be like 4 days, or how, you know, just however long I want to spend some time off. Like if I'm like really near to the end of the game and I'm really itching to get back into it, I'll probably only take a couple of days off. But you know, like once a week. Once a month, I'll take a few days off, usually about the second week, probably. So yeah, tell me in the comment section below, have you seen this kind of encodable redstone system before? Have you not seen it before? Is this like the first place you've seen it? And if you have seen it before, tell me where, because I haven't seen it. Like, someone's probably already made this, and I've just not known, but I could very possibly, but unlikely, be the first person to have used it in this way. Yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.